the Lord loved us so much that in our poverty, in our hell, I would come and deliver the broken, destroyed, messed up, poor, impoverished people I'm going to save.
Hey, Shalom Israel, Yahweh Bashimel Shadrach a Thug, Yahweh Shema'al a Thug, Bashimel Shadrach all the sisters, man. Listen, it's Captain 13,000, the Card of a Rhyme, checking in with the Israelite School of UPK, under Commander Jerry Hunt. Listen, man, this year's 52nd annual Passover. Hold on, I'm gonna say it one more time. This year's 52nd annual Passover under Commander Jerry Hunter under the ISUPK. Couldn't do it last year. Y'all already know the Lord had his foot on our oppressor's neck.
Here in New York City, there are roughly 1,000 cases a day. Those are numbers they haven't seen since May.
Can't do it in New York this year because the Lord still got his foot on our oppressor's neck.
New York, the center of the outbreak this spring, is now teetering on another deadly explosion of the virus.
But listen to me good. This year, 52nd annual Passover, April 24th, 2021. You understand? It's going to be in H-Town, baby.
It's going to be at the B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Y'all know what we do. Y'all know what we came to do. Huh? 2021, ISUPK, 52nd annual Passover. All the generals gonna be there. All the heavy hitters gonna be there. The daughters of Zion gonna step out with their beautiful long dresses, you understand? Strong on deck. That One West style music on deck. 52nd annual Passover.
B&H Ranch, 14149 Player Street, Houston, Texas.
Get with it to get lost, man.
Got it out the mud, straight up out the base. The world done made me crazy. The world done turned crazy.
You dealing with the men of war. We at war. I sided with the Lord, of course. On one accord. We ain't never stopping now. You running now. All my niggas go to ground. We go.
If we look around, look like a movie. Look, the stores are boarded up. Business is down, the economy is down. You got military points everywhere. It looks like a movie, man. But this is real life. What's real life? Racism, man. Those Donald Trump supporters, they were losing their savior. They were losing a great white hope. Donald Trump has woken up the beast. We thought because of democracy, we thought America was post-racial. We thought everything was behind. They thought a new America was coming after Obama. But no, Donald Trump said, let's build a wall. Donald Trump said, bad hombres, and white people and the oppressor said yes. He got them hype. And after that, man, it was over. Donald Trump was their great white hope. When he said, build the wall, they loved it. They said, yeah, build that wall. Donald Trump said, bad hombres, and Donald Trump said, Latinos were rapists. And they said, yeah, those Latinos are bad. And now that Donald Trump's leaving out of office, Trump supporters feel like they're leaving their country. So what they had to do? They had to go and invade the Capitol and steal them and stop the vote. And stop the voting, man.
Right.
They try to steal the votes, man. And in that, they killed. They were violent. They killed a Capitol policeman. And Ashley Bambi got shot in the neck. She got put in the dirt. She had to get put in the dirt. She got put in the dirt. Damn. Secret Service is smoking on Ashley Bambi tonight. They had to put her in the dirt because she tried to break the barrier, man. Secret Service said, send more of them. Send more bandits, man. We're gonna send you more in the box, man. You oppressors are out of control. You're fighting each other, but it's beautiful for black and Latinos, man. It's beautiful. Black man, you ain't got to do nothing but watch. Get your popcorn, get your favorite drink, and pour a shot and take a shot, man.
That's
right. Sit back and watch the movies.
That's right.
Look, we thought the movies was locked down because of COVID. Nah, it's right here in real life. The movies is right here in real life, man. And the movie is titled The Fall of America.
That's right.
And the rise of a black kingdom and a Latino kingdom under a black man named Jesus Christ, man. Give me Exodus, give me the Apocrypha. Give me 2 Ezra, man. This is God wants this to happen. America will never be the same. And history was made. The Capitol was invaded, man. History was made. History repeated itself. Oppressor on oppressor crime. Y'all love to talk about black on black crime. And oppressor just rolled past here and said, "What about the blood and the Crips? Stop killing each other. What about Trump? What about the Trump supporters invading the Capitol? Devil. What about that? Listen, man. Listen. The blood and the Crips. We can dissolve it. That's nothing. Y'all made history last week. Y'all the reason why the police got to post up. Look, y'all the reason the police, y'all the reason D.C. got a lot, the mayor has to lock down D.C. and cut off exits, man.
Right.
And put roadblocks up.
Right.
You can't get no damn way in Northwest. It's ridiculous, man.
Right.
But this is what you cause. And we have no, and black man, you should have no problem with it, man. Who you at? Give me 2 Ezra, man. The city is locked down over racism, man. Where we at? 2 Ezra? Chapter 15, verse 16. This was prophesied in the Bible that wars will come. And they were, and that nation will fight nation, man. Oh, she got to get it. Good night. He gave him the turn right there. You gotta go in. 2 Ezra, chapter 15, verse 16. For there shall be sedition among men. Sedition, man. There was sedition amongst men. And sedition is against the law. Though everybody's supposed to be locked up, man. Go in. For there shall be sedition among men. And invading one another, they shall not regard their kings nor princes. And sedition is the conduct or the speech inciting people to rebel against the authority of a state or monarch, man. That's exactly what happened. Donald Trump incited his supporters to invade that Capitol. And he tried to act innocent. But Donald Trump incited that riot. That's what he did. He deserved. Put Donald Trump in a cage where he belongs.
Right.
Put him in jail because he broke the law. They call Black Lives Matter a terrorist group. Nah, Black Lives Matter have never killed a Capitol police officer. Black Lives Matter did not kill a cop. But them rednecks, them Proud Boys.
That's right.
Woo! They go, listen, man, it was a movie. It was amazing. Amazing, man. Listen, they got whatever they could get. They went to they stormed the Capitol. Broke the glass, broke the windows, hopped in. And man, listen, made work, broke into offices, they looted, they stole podiums and all types of government things that were hanging on the wall and everything. Government mail, that's a crime. That's a felony. They stealing mail. Listen, man. You are criminals. You oppressors are criminals, man. The Lord is showing who the true criminal is. Donald Trump is a criminal. His supporters are criminals. And Joe Biden, he ain't free either. All of them are criminals too, man. They disgusting too. The Lord is going to show who the real animal is. And it's you oppressors. You here fighting, you all fighting each other. The right versus the left.
Right.
Democrat versus Republican, man.
That's right.
Black man, you don't join that fight either. Your job is to come back to God. Your job is to come back and obey God's laws and let the Lord deal with America. The vengeance is the Lord's. Listen, and that shows you, them Trump supporters don't support God. They took vengeance into their own hand because they are bloody people. Go in.
Thank you.
They shall not regard their kings nor princes. They do not regard. What happened to democracy? Listen, it's supposed to be fair. Voting, I thought voting was supposed to be fair. Everybody cast a vote in the ballot, and whoever gets the most votes, they win. If you don't like it, wait till the next 4 years. But listen, to this election, they weren't having that. They said, oh, hell no, my great white hope, Donald Trump, the great white hope, he cannot leave. If he leaves, my rights will be taken from me. They wanted to fight for their rights, man. They love Donald Trump more. Don't Trump supporters love Donald Trump more than Christ? Christ is their new, listen, Donald Trump is their new Christ. That's their great white Messiah, Donald Trump. Go ahead, man. You people are criminals, man. And the Lord is going to reveal who you are on the earth. Go ahead. And the course of their actions shall stand in their power. Read from when they shall stand against their king. Read. They shall not regard their kings nor princes. Listen, man. The Trump supporters did not regard. They do not regard Joe Biden. They do not believe Joe Biden. They don't believe he fairly won. They believe he stole it. They believe he stole the vote. He stole the election. So they say, you know what? We're gonna invade the Capitol, and we're gonna stop the electoral votes. We're gonna stop it, man. It's ridiculous. They all need to go to jail.
That's right.
Just like they tell us. They tell black people, lock them up. Lock them up and throw away the key.
Right.
Listen, you white presidents need to go to jail.
That's right.
If you storm that Capitol, you need to go to jail.
That's right.
And the leader, Donald J. Trump, who incited the riot, he needs to go to jail right along with him.
Right.
He needs to be the first one. You got to get special handcuffs for Donald little hands and little wrists. His hands are little. Make sure you get some custom cuffs for them little hands and throw that devil in a jail. Because that's where he belongs. He's a criminal. He's a little hand criminal, man. Go ahead.
And the course of their actions shall stand in their power. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able.
Listen, man. Wait a minute. That's right now. What's today's date? Today, the 16th? This Bible was written thousands of years ago. And it said that the people in the city will fight against each other, and they are not going to regard their king. And it also said, what a man shall what?
A man shall desire to go into a city.
Some people want to come to D.C. today. They're going to want to come to D.C. During inauguration. But what?
And shall not be able.
You shall not be able to. Because of chaos. Because of unorderly conduct. Because of murder. Because of criminal acts, man. And you know, the city is locked down. And that is written in the Bible, man. Read on.
For because their pride, the cities shall be troubled.
And the cities shall be troubled, man, for their pride. They just, listen, just take the L. You can't even, listen, the Trump supporters can't even take an L. They said, damn that, they've been taking L's too long. But they see the racism in Donald Trump. They've been racist all this time, but they've been racist amongst each other. But Donald Trump came and riled them up. And Donald Trump was speaking them redneck's language. Donald Trump was speaking the language of the KKK.
Right.
Donald Trump was speaking the language of them Proud Boys.
Right.
So you know what? They said, that is my Messiah.
That's right.
They said, he's the man. He's the man that get the job done. And leave it up to them. They want Trump in office for 20 years.
Right.
Leave it to them.
Right.
That's how racist they are. And listen, they were fueled by racism. They were fueled when Donald Trump said, build that wall. When Donald Trump said, bad hombres. When Donald Trump said, no illegal immigrants. When Donald Trump was against so-called black people, that's what fueled them so-called far-right supporters and Trump supporters. They were fueled and gassed up by racism. And they felt like they was losing their country. And finally, somebody that's speaking that language could be the president, be the king. They loved that. That's why they were willing to kill their own people and destroy the capital for their king. Where you at? You can drop that. What verse was that, Salaki? The last verse you was on. Read on. The houses shall be destroyed, and men shall be afraid. They were looting, and men were afraid. If you would have seen the fear on the Capitol Police, it was ridiculous. But guess what? That's what you get. That's what. Listen, just like Captain Mashok said, just like the Bible says, you reap what you sow. Because them Capitol policemen are racist, and they have made other black people fear. They have pulled over black people and held them at gunpoint and made black innocent black people and unarmed black people shake in fear. So now guess what? Your own brothers that are Trump supporters broke in, and them Capitol policemen were crying and shaking with fear. Welcome to black America. Welcome to black America. We shake in fear every damn day of our life. We shake in fear every minute, 24/7, man. Because we know how dangerous you are. We know how murderous and destructive you are, man. We know how bloodthirsty the police force is and the Capitol Police are. So we shake in fear every day. You just got a taste of your own medicine when those Donald Trump supporters invaded the Capitol, man. You got a taste of your own medicine. The chickens came home to roost. Give me same book. Give me 2 Thessalonians 9:1. Now we got to address black people and Latinos and American Indians. What are we to do when Americans fight against each other? What are we to do? We thought America was going to somehow, if we protest and talk to them, we thought that they would take care of. We thought that we could seek justice from them. They can't even seek justice within themselves. Between themselves, man. We will never get justice from them. They fight each other. You got to come to God. God gonna give you that justice, man. The Lord is gonna give us that justice, and we got to remember Him. That's all we got to do. Our job is to remember God. And remember His laws and statutes, and He's gonna take care of the rest. He's gonna avenge us, man. He's gonna serve us up a good heaping plate, a heavy plate of justice, man, and make us rulers of this earth if we obey His voice. Go ahead. No, so go ahead. You can go ahead and read that. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 1. Finally, brethren, pray for us that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified. Chapter 2, verse 3. Let no man deceive you by any means. Let no man deceive you, man. Everybody, listen, we living in the last days. We are living in the last days. And do not let these Democrats deceive you. If we just listen, Joe Biden's selling all kind of lies. Right. He said he's gonna pay for your student loans. He said he's gonna send a third stimulus package, and this one gonna be $2,000 and whatever. We shall see. Those men, listen, let no man deceive you. Go in. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come. That day should not come. Peace is not coming back on the earth. Peace is not going to come back on the earth for you, black man, until a black man cracked that sky. That's when your peace is coming. And if you want that peace, you will separate yourself from America, man. That don't mean you have to move out, because some crazy nuts think you got to go live and go live on across seas, man. Go live in Asia and all type of places to separate from America. That ain't it. You got to take your spirit up out of this place. You gotta know that you are not safer here. You gotta know that you are living amongst your enemy. Go in.
Except there come a falling away first.
Black man, if you want peace, you gotta fall away from something first. You gotta fall away from something first. You gotta fall away from loving America, man. You gotta fall away from this Christmas. You gotta fall away from getting involved in these politics. A lot of us black people are Democrats. And right now you feel involved. You feel like, man, look at Trump. Trump is so evil. We voted for Biden. And now he's trying to stay in office. He's not trying to get out. Look at his supporters. His supporters are invading the Capitol. Black man, Joe Biden's gonna put you in jail. Joe Biden's gonna put you in hell also. Just because Trump is gone and Biden is in office, do not mean your life is gonna be better. You have to look at Joe Biden's history and Kamala Harris' history. Kamala Harris is famous for locking black people up and not giving a damn. Even if they're innocent, She did not even care about submitting evidence to help get black people, innocent black men, and innocent black people out of jail. Kamala Harris don't give a damn at all. So just because Trump is out of office, don't mean it's over. We gotta come back to God, man. The Lord we gotta come back to obeying Him. I know you think you obeying God when you go to church on Sunday. They ain't teaching us how to obey God in there. They want to steal your money, man. Go ahead.
Except there come a falling away first.
We gotta fall away from voting. Black man, your biggest mistake, Latino, your biggest mistake is voting. Don't vote Trump and do not vote Biden. Neither party is gonna help your black behind. If Trump is in office, you're gonna get shot by the cops. If Biden is in office, you're gonna get shot by the cops. Death is on both sides, man. You gotta come back to the Most High, God. Biden is not your savior. Go ahead.
And the man of sin be revealed.
And that man of sin be revealed. Listen. Look at the police. Look at the military. They armed to the teeth, man. They armed to the teeth. Read it again.
And that man of sin be revealed.
Listen, the police ain't out here for nothing. The police are not out here for nothing. The military points are not here for nothing. They are trying to protect the Capitol and protect DC from a violent people, from violent Trump supporters, and violent people on the far right, man. They're trying to secure the Capitols, not only in DC, but also in Oregon, in Arizona, and in other places, because what? DC, listen. DC is not the only place that got capitals. They are violent oppressors and Trump supporters. They're trying to invade all capitals in America, man. And now the city is on lockdown. It looks like a movie out here. It looks like a movie, don't it? This does not look like life. Look at the stores. Everything boarded up. The stores are boarded up. Business is down, the streets are empty. This looks like a movie. And guess what, man?
God bless you.
The Lord God is the director. God is the executive director of all these things. The COVID, the famines, the disease, the wars and rumors of wars, God is the executive producer.
Right.
Go ahead.
And that man of sin be revealed.
And that man of sin be revealed. He broke the law, man. Sedition is against treason, is breaking the law. Sedition, inciting a riot against the government, is breaking the law. It's a crime. The man of sin is our oppressor. The man of sin is the men that run America, man. Donald Trump and Joe Biden are the men of sin. Go in. And they cannot save you, black and Latino. Go in. The son of perdition. The son of perdition, the son of sin. Go in. Who opposeth and exalted himself above all that is called God. Right. Who is the person that exalted himself above God? America, man. America has changed the laws of God. America changed the laws of God. Donald Trump, he don't mind if you murder, he doesn't mind if the police murder black people.
Right.
And Joe Biden, he doesn't mind creating same-sex restrooms. He doesn't mind liberating homosexuals.
Right.
And homosexuality is a sin against God. He doesn't mind. He's a son of sin. Donald Trump is a son of sin. They don't mind. And Kamala Harris, his vice president, she said that she's willing to legalize prostitution, which is a sin against God. These are filthy people on both sides, left and right. Then guess what? The left wing cannot fly without the right wing. The whole eagle, the whole bird is dirty, man. The whole bird is sinful. And the Lord is going to bring that bird down.
If you love the ISUPK, stay in the loop. Go to Google Play and download the new user-friendly One West ISUPK app and get exclusive footage to our online classes and street speaking videos. Also, the Black Watch podcast, hosted by Commanding General Yohanna, the leader of the Nation of Israel. It's real easy to stay in tune with the ISUPK and the information we're putting out. Just go to Google Play and type in One West UPK app and hit download. Let's get it in. Don't be left out.